Seeing that the California has problems flooding is interesting, but not much I can do about it. Here's the one I wanted to see. The Beaufort takes pictures of Champion, hidden among everything else down here. The others are spotting reports, kill claims. Ah, here's the good stuff at the end. The fortifications expanding. Great, great, great. Japanese forces capture and the Babel Daob expands to size 4. Reinforcements arrive. Okay. And here's the penalty. We paid 2 yesterday. Accumulated political point penalty is 2 daily, and we've already paid 2 for yesterday when we should have withdrawn the photo reconnaissance group. Let's go to that photo reconnaissance group right now and take care of it first. We have the photo reconnaissance group here at Kuala Lumpur, but we also have pilots here. We want to keep the pilots, but not and get rid of the planes. So what we will do is, let's see, what was that? We did last time, to group reserve, move it to group reserve, move it to group reserve. These are, okay, so this is the number 100 squadron. Oh, let's just try to remember the names. Number 100 squadron, Stevenson, Fitzgibbon, and Ross. Kind of, yeah, something else to remember or write down, isn't it? Okay, so we've got this squadron here. There's another reconnaissance squadron in Singapore. We'll take the recon types. We can't draw it. So, let's see. Okay, we'll hit A to bring up all the aircraft. We'll check for recon types. We'll check all nations, and this one belongs to the British, so we have to go with Kuala Lumpur. Boy, oh boy, what sucky, sucky choice. Let's check a patrol route. The Patrol Catalina is here. We can't pull them out in the Patrol Catalinas. They're full with pilots as well. Float planes, full with pilots. Transports. That's a hell of a way to go. We need such experienced pilots that we're willing to take them anywhere. Okay, so the Buffaloes here are going to try to grab those pilots out. We're going to request a veteran. All groups. Well, we could sort through all this stuff. We're going to go with the reserve. These are just the general reserve. We don't want to take those. Tradecom or group. Okay, so this is the 3. We have Fitzgibbon, Stevenson, and Ross. The experience is 52, 35. Let's see. Let's try to... If we take the pilot... Yes. Let's see what the Fitz. What's the other one? Ross. Yes. And Stevenson. Yes, so they're all in the 50s. Let's take a look at the pilots and see that there's Ross, Fitzgibbon. They're down to 51 and Stevenson's 54. So I guess this one took a hit, but the other two didn't. Is that correct? We may be wrong there. I may have just grabbed the Ross. I may have forgotten Ross. So the other ones don't seem to have lost anything on the experience. But now they're fighter pilots. What every good recon pilot wants to be. With the... Okay, this detachment, now that it's gone, we could fill it up with pilots, but I don't think so. We have none. No pilots in here. We're going to... If we disband it, let's see. Can we disband it? Not allowed. May not disband. Past withdrawal date. Okay, so we cannot disband it because it is past its withdrawal date, so we need to withdraw. Group will be withdrawn and pilots disabled planes may be lost. Okay. Goodbye. So where'd the fighter pilots go? Ah, it was here. So we've saved three experienced fighter pilots, kind of experienced. This guy's no got nothing. A rookie. He was probably a replacement we pulled in there. Back to China. Another boost for my units. Monitoring my units. This one heading to the northeast. We've got plenty of time. Notice, oh, and this one moving to the west. Notice it says it's moving towards the enemy, and there's a river in the way. These are nice little warnings. They've been added. These are nice changes. I don't know how recent, but they're nice to let you know that there's a river that you're going to cause a shock attack if you go across. The airfield at Rangoon is just getting chewed up. The air group, too. We've only got three buffaloes left. To try to help them, we're going to expand. The Moolmin is going to go range of 2 and flying at 70% with Major Boyington. Another transport arrives. Oh, we've increased a little bit of supply there. Okay. Perhaps there's a bright light at the end of the tunnel, and it's not an oncoming train. The brigades arrive on the frontier, and we set them to work. The Wapiti at Cochin have repaired the Lysander, so we're going to try to fly them down to Kogala. There we go. At Abaddon, I'm realizing that we're never going to be able to finish off or load. Except for Karachi, we're never going to get all the supply or get low enough because it's such a low level already. So we're going to load what we can. If it happens to be more fuel, whatever. Anything we load is better than nothing that we'll bring back. So we're setting it and heading it for Karachi. I think that it's better to take the fuel right to the front because of all the transmission loss. But when the submarine threat gets really bad, we'll just load them up. Just go by mass. Just load as much as a few million points of supply or fuel here should somehow at least trickle down to with the disastrous RAF attacks on the ground forces. Not worth the. We're going back to naval attack. And 10% search. Don't know what we're going to do up here. If 400 men couldn't hold a defensive position, how are 300? Not even 300. 300 here. Well, now it's obvious even to an idiot like me that the enemy is coming down the road, not down this road. So we're going to pack up. Everyone move back to Tumalo. We'll set it for Singapore, as if anyone's ever going to see that place. We'll be blasted out of our positions long before. Lots of subs in Singapore. Repairing. More weapons? Oh, I think this indicates the weapons tube that was damaged. How much? What size? Yeah, some are very high, and some can't even be repaired. In a sub, at a certain port. But these are okay. What's that? 2. Yep, we've reloaded. Off we go. I don't. Which now? Where should we aim? We have a destroyer and a battleship up here, so we are detecting them. We're just not intercepting them. We've got the reaction set to 1. Sure, it would be nice to bag a capital ship, a warship, instead of these little merchants. The refugee fleet is in Sor Baha. We take the big one. We have some damage on the ships, so we're going to transfer them in to the dry dock for hopefully for a quick repair. We'll transfer the other task force. Ooh, wow. There's some pretty... Thanet still has some damage on it. We will load up fuel for everyone. Look at that. No supply whatsoever. Dry as a bone. We have ships on here. We'll try to get them in the shipyard. Kongwo, minesweeper. With a little luck, everyone will be out in a day. The replenished group in Darwin is almost finished unloading, and they volunteer to go back to Palembang. Palembang still has some supplies and quite a bit of fuel. Darwin is up to 15,000 or so right now. With the additional, would make it over 20,000. Which supply gets burned very quickly when the shooting starts. The Royal Navy Transport Group is still loading supplies, but that's it. We're close. Close. No, we could load more supplies, but the fact that we are without any naval support makes it quite a difficult task. So we're going to sail now. We'll let the other ships load the small lighters load and bring supply behind them. So who's coming with us? Who's got the fuel? We've got the Sun Chaser. We'll bring Sun Chaser. She can bring a little bit of fuel, but she ties up the dock when she has to refuel, when she has to unload. Yeah, I don't think freighter tankers unload very well offshore. The assumption is each ship will have small ships boats that unload stuff, but it's very slow to go over a crane. So we've got. All these little ships, we may as well use them. They can switch it in and out. We'll send, 3, 4. Yeah, it's a big convoy, so we're going to send a big escort. The other ships, the little ships that got left behind, turn off it. The tanker will unload. While the little, AKL. What else can we can't send anything, so we'll just load up. We won't refuel, won't steal the fuel. We'll just load supply. Ground unit wise, there's no one to really, we can buy and send combat units, but they're not going to help us build the damn thing. Nothing really with engineers around here. So we'll send. Yeah, these guys have engineers, but it's too big a unit. So we'll get the Royal Navy unit up there. Hopefully, it will be able to help everyone else unload. Here comes the 4th Royal Navy base, and it has naval support, 50 points worth of naval support. So hopefully, the next evolution will be smoother. The Americans are trying to drop off their artillery. Okay, this is motorized support. Takes a little while. I think there's already motorized support does not have a problem unloading. No, that's aviation. There, motorized support can be unloaded. Yes. It just takes more time. Unfortunately, we have these sound detectors, which I think are impossible to unload over a beach, over a level one base. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this AP. He's got motorized and gun support, but he's 10,000 tons, so he's much bigger than can be taken. This one has lots more, so we're going to switch out the MEGs. Transfer. Okay. Undock, transfer. The MEGs will come in. Look at all this clicking. Look at all this clicking for that simple little thing. The MEGs is going to stay there. We'll take the Coast Farmer. And now we have to go back to the other one. MEGs. Oh, it's too big. It's 6,090, so it's 90 tons too big. All right, so can anyone tell me which one will fit? Nope, we have a 6,000 ton limit here. So just looking at it, there's no way you're gonna find out which one. You can guess, but you know where you'll find it. So the only way to do it, you got it, click. Ah, this one, or this one will do. This is motorized support. This is motorized. Well, this is also most motorized support. Coast Farmer only has two motorized support squads left to unload. Alstead has six. Bloemfontein is too big, 8,000 tons. So we'll order. It's the Halsted that we'll take. What a pain, huh? What a pain! All right, now we got to transfer back the MEGs. Transfer over. Now we have to dock it. Really? Really? We have a number of supplies on the base, but no engineers, so we can't be building anything. I'm just going to set it to expand anyway. We've got supplies and a number of units. Hopefully the enemy hasn't detected us yet. This unit is about to drop. We'll make sure we unload, and this unit's set to unload. Double check. We don't want to make a mistake now. Unit is combined, and we're escorting it in. Here are the transports. Here are the other transports. We didn't bring enough destroyers to share the escorts, so we'll have to send them off here. Okay, that should be plenty of time to intercept. The enemy carrier group has been running. We've been heading out here, patrol zone. Let's set the patrol zone out in front of them and try to catch them. We've taken a lot of damage to the ship, not a lot, but heavy damage to the ship by running at very high speed, and we're not running out of fuel, but we're using up the fuel. Let's see if we can't catch them and bomb the living daylights out of them. The search planes seem to have tracked them, but that sure was scary. Now we have to change plans. We'll form up transport. Antares, we'll have to dock and unload without taking the fuel. I'm glad did we leave any tenders back here? Nope. I took them all. So we'll drop off a couple of tenders from here as we go past. Yeah. As we go past, we'll drop a few tenders, and then they can come back and help serve these little locations. We're at 30% left, so the next one, are we going to load any? No. We'll be building. May as well. Use it. We'll set it for Fanning Island to return to Fanning Island. Disband into Fanning Island, trying to pick up this detachment. Other base, yeah, look how slowly it drove, maybe 5% per day. We have construction here. We might as well expand the port. Not the airfield. It's going to take a major construction effort for that, so we can't do that. Let's just expand the building. We have a level 2 airfield. We'll have to be satisfied with that much. Christmas Island is better shape. Johnson. Yeah, this is going to airfield expansion is going to be nearly impossible. Are we just burning good supply for nothing? Probably. Unless we get an aviation engineering aviation battalion in here, I don't foresee this changing. But she's close enough, we can burn a little supply. We'll try. The subs that were already here didn't detect anyone coming through. Damn it. So we're going to send them. Oh, well, why not? Why don't we just... Yeah, let's send them to Midway. We'll return to Midway. Refuel. We're using this as a forward operating base, so let's use it. A submarine base. It's got a submarine tender here. So we'll base out of here and make it a little bit closer to Japan. We have still loading. It looks like I don't have a choice. I'm going to send the little island mail ship off right now because it's a small ship and it's a different speed than the others. So she'll be slowing them down regardless. Whew, difficult to say. Let's send her to Pearl Harbor because we just had two sunk over there. So yeah, I think we need it. We can send it with the E. Well, these are loaded already. We could just send it. Okay, we'll send three of them. Transfer a fully loaded one, almost fully loaded one. The other ships. So now we have room to load, but no supplies, not enough supplies to load. All right, Pearl Harbor is going to set up her surface combat, and we'll send the escorts. Not a hell of a lot of escorts. We sent most of them with following number. Who's following whom? I think we're following number 99. No, it's not. We're following number 201. Okay. I think I stated previous video, we want to follow. Hopefully with a follow command, our superior speed will just let us catch it. With a meet command, the leading ships will slow down so that the following ships can catch them. Here comes our carrier. We've detected the submarine here. Queen Elizabeth has arrived home. Check her and we see that she will withdraw within 120 days. Here's a good thing to check. Now that we've been penalized for failure to withdraw an air group, we can also check the ships. We can call up the ship command, S hotkey, and show ships withdrawing within the next 90 days. There we go. Next 90 days. So this one's going to be a little while longer. We have the task force withdrawing the Dominion Monarch over near Australia and another transport. So 44 and 60 days, plenty of time. Here's Miss Lady Battleship. heading in to refuel and disband. So let's take a look at Queen Elizabeth. We have a dock here for 140. Queen Elizabeth is 50,000 tons. Whoa. Okay, we replenished, disband her. How long will it take to repair her? 23 days? 12 days. Wow. She really damaged herself. Did she get hit? I didn't see her get hit. Okay. We've got these at pier side. Oh, these are the what do you call them? We'll put out in readiness. These are the conversions, that's what it is. So we've taken up, out of the 90,000, we've taken up 50,000. Unfortunately, I can't break these up for fear of this. So we'll set it for the, which one? This one has a 90,000 and 180,000. Let's go to Alameda. And then we'll shuffle the battleships to various dry docks so that each facility has so many points. And so it's better to spread them out. Repairs get done more quickly. I wanted to use the ones in the south, but I didn't have escorts. I may shuffle them afterwards, the battleships down here, just to use up these docking facilities. A Kingfisher unit has arrived. Now the real question is, should I just do as the other ones are doing? The Kingfishers are nice in the sense that they can do anything. They can do bomb missions, they can train for all kinds. So do we have any for naval attack? Yes. Oh, we should have the Vindicator here. Where's the Vindicator? Vindicator and Dauntless for naval attack already. So we don't have enough. The Catalinas are flying real missions, so we don't have enough for training for search. We'll use search. We'll drop the pilots out. Search level low. If you notice, for the ones we're training, the low level, all of our low level flights, pilots increase the defensive numbers. So this is where they can grow up. Low-level training increases their defensive capabilities. And there's the air-to-air threat capabilities that have been increasing every day. We've returned to Annette Island. Amphibious. Okay, let's try to load both of them. No, we can't do it. Verify load. Wow. Well, we can try. We'll turn off everything. Verify. Accept. Yep. Then we'll head back to Prince Rupert. Auto disband. We already have a unit here. This is the United States base. Let's see. Naval support. Yep. We don't want any replacements yet because there are still forward bases needing them, but we'll send it down to San Francisco. In Portland, no, that's the Canadian effort. In Seattle, we'll make sure that all of our units are switched. I'm thinking of flying one out. Okay, Cornwallis. We don't have much air coverage here. Oh, we can't. No, I can't get the. I don't want to buy out the aircraft. Oh, we can't move these aircraft. They are stuck in Canada. Double checking on the operational report. The regiment and the division arrive at Los Angeles and Marchfield. We send them off to San Francisco. These can be purchased, so we send them off to San Francisco. When we have more points, we will buy them out and send them forward. We'll check the other. We have reinforcements at Batavia, Perth. Oh, we missed the one at Perth. Batavia and Perth. The transport at Perth is going out. Oh, why do they What the hell? Oh, it's not. Jeez. Told it. Okay, return to Cape Town. Let's see the path. Right, straight off. That's good. Clear the approaches as soon as possible in case there are submarines. There's a anchor here. What showed up at Cape Town? Cape Town has reinforcements, right? So we'll form transport. Okay. We have, let's see. Okay, well, 3 units, so we may as well pick up all 3 units. They're anti-aircraft artillery. Yep. We'll set them for Cochin. Turn off the refuel. Any other units that we may have missed? Oh, Batavia. Yes, Batavia had an air unit arrive. Naval. Oh, two of them. We've missed the Catalina before. Must have been another one. Okay, naval search. Naval search has been pretty dismal for my units. The enemy seems to be still able to sail wherever he darn well pleases. We'll take replacements, but we got no pilots to fly them. So, what else is new? This is okay, Batavia. Where's the other? Oh, was this tr which unit arrived? Was this the only one, or did I mistake it? Okay, this must have been the one. I thought there would have been another one here. Singkawang had a lot of air combat. Now the fighters are totally knocked out, disabled. So I'm going to try to bring some in from Surabaya. I don't know which the best are. Okay. Which base was that? It is Singkawang. Okay. Well, I guess we should see if we could reach it first. These cannot fly far enough. Next. We can. Here we go. Turn off the training. Escort 100. We'll send. Try to get up to Palembang. Nope, we can't get that far. The demons, can they get up to Palembang? They can't get that far. All right, so let's try sending them up to Batavia. Then we'll make the jump next turn. We don't have any real fighters. We have, that's it. We have, those are the only fighters we have here. So we've got a fighter squadron here, fighter squadron here, fighter squadron here, and 3 over on. Another reinforcement missed is the artillery. We'll move it up to fight on at Clark Field if we can. Ah, this is one we forgot too. Boy, we forget a lot. We've got the patrol zone heading out for. Wow, let's use the direct. And the base home is Lingayen. Hopefully, we'll expend something. Set a patrol zone. Okay, here's one patrol zone boundary, two patrol zone boundaries. So we'll sail through both of them, hopefully to engage something, and then fall back here to retire. We can't create any more PT boats. Clark Field is shut down. So move the. We're just getting blasted for no reason. We will transfer the base over to Manila. This is US Army. Okay, we'll fill it up with regular pilots. fly over. Where are you? Manila. Everyone off the base. Oops. Yeah, we'll just grab pilots here. Even the Catalinas. Of course, this means Manila is just well, way over stacked. Okay, the escorts are flying at 10,000. If he hits Clark, he just has to hit Clark. He's captured another base in the south, moving, so he's moving up this rail line slowly but surely. We're now in contention with Bayombong. So time to rebuild. We've been trying to put up barricades, but build the fortifications, but without any luck. Prince of Wales is sailing past, so we need to form a combat group. Which shall we send with her? We'll send 3 destroyers. Float them out to here, at which time we should be able to leave them. The PT boats dive into the attack. Several hits. PT boats strike again. Look at that. We're getting mine layers, destroyer minesweepers, and transports. Some P2 boats also lost. A third run. Seal fires. Oh no. A night air attack on Manila. This time, Warhawks are available. Seal fires again. Shark fires. I think it's a dud. The PT boats are still around. Sculpin fires. Pike fires. Dolphin fires. Finally, Dolphin gets a hit. Rangoon under attack. The Flying Tigers show up. Rabaul bombed. Rangoon bombed again. RAF attack on the ships. Another RAF attack. A third RAF attack. The fortresses attack, but miss again. Fortresses attack transports at Legazpi. Manila under attack. Several casualties. Manila under attack. Kansien bombed. Mulmayan under attack. Heavy casualties both sides. Afternoon air attack, Manila. 10 sallies destroyed. Ground attack, Luoyang. Air attack, Kukong. Kuilin bombed. Clarkfield bombed. No defenders. The RAF launches one final attack against the transports. Seawolf fires torpedoes. Dolphin fires torpedoes. Bombardment at Chusien. Bombardment at Kwe Sui. Bombardment at Nanning. Japanese attack at Bayombong. 1-2 odds. Ground attack, Chumphong. Shock attack. 76-1 odds. One unit totally destroyed.